Hello students, how are you all? Doing good? Yes. So students, we have already covered a lot of topics from our class 6 social science syllabus, isn't it? So today in this video, we are going to start a new topic from our geography. Okay. So, as we have already finished geography lesson number 1, so in this video we are starting geography lesson number 2. So, before we start discussing about our geography 2, let's have a short recap, or I want to test how much do you remember about geography 1. Okay, first thing, what was the name of the geography lesson number 1? It was the Earth in the solar system. And what were the topics that you have learnt in that, students? You have learnt about celestial bodies. That means all the objects or things that are placed in the space are called as celestial bodies. That includes our sun, planets, asteroids, meteors. So all these things will be including. And we have also seen that how are these stars formed? And how this solar system have also formed, right? And other things, when all these stars, or we say when few stars make a particular shape of an object or a person, then it is called as constellations. Yes. So the example of constellation what we have learnt in geography lesson number 1 is Ursa Major, Great Bear. So we have seen about all these constellations, right? Other than that, we have seen about the solar system. So what does our solar system consist of? It will be having sun at the center, around it all the planets revolving. Okay, then we have seen about the moon, that are it's like satellite. So it is our natural satellite, and many other planets are also having satellites. They may have more than 2 or 3 or 4 moons also. Then we have seen about asteroids, in which belt they will be found. They will be in between Mars and Jupiter. Yes. So, and they also say that those piece of rocks are nothing but a planet might have exploded, and those particles are only being in that path, in that gap. Okay. Next, we have seen about meteors, piece of rocks that will be moving around the sun. Yes, students, so these were the some topics. Now, when we come back to our solar system, so the things which those are very important for us when we are discussing solar system is planets. So how many planets do we have? We are having 8 planets. Yes. So earlier we used to have 9. We used to include Pluto also, but now we are not including Pluto. Okay, so now we are having 8 planets. So you all remember all the planets, right? And how to remember in a sequence? There is a very interesting shortcut also. I hope you all remember that. Okay. Now, the planet on which we reside, students, it is Earth. Yes. Earth only, no? Or do we reside on Mercury? No? We reside on Earth? Okay, so we have seen about Earth, and you were learning about the Earth from many years. You might have studied certain topics in your class 3, 4 also, and in your class 5 also you have learned. Now, student, what is the size of the Earth? It is very small. Can we fit in a room? No. In our country? No. On our continent? No. Because it is very huge, and all the things that we are talking, mentioning, are on the Earth. So, how can we study about the Earth? We cannot get it. We cannot see that. No, then what is the other thing that we use to study about the globe, which almost replicates, or we can see the exact globe or exact Earth? So we usually use globe for studying the Earth, right? So, are both Earth and globe same, students? Are they same? They are same only in terms of looks. So, they look alike, but rest all things are different. The size is different. The way they move around the sun is different. Yes, and the globe will be having many lines over it, whereas Earth doesn't have. Yes, so these are many differences. As we said, they are not similar in size. Okay, so the lines that we were talking, those are the imaginary lines and very important. And those lines are called as, do you know, few horizontal and few vertical lines will be there. Do you know those lines? They are the latitudes and longitudes. So, our topic is, so, students, as we said that we will be using globe for referring or studying the Earth, as this is the three-dimensional, 3D model of Earth. But it is in miniature. Miniature, students, it's nothing but it is greatly reduced in the size. Okay, so the size of, as we already discussed, the size of the Earth and globe are not same. So, it has reduced in very huge amount. Okay, now this 3D is, that means it will be having three dimensions. Okay, other than globe, students, sometimes we will be using map also for studying about the Earth. But it is said that globes are more accurate, they are more correct when we compare it to a map. Because when all the continents and ocean they are placing on a map, it is said that the size of the continents and countries will be little bit changed. Whereas on the globe, it can be accurately presented. Okay, they will be accurately presented. Fine. So, this is how we can learn about the globe. And students, nowadays we find a lot of different types of globes. Some globes are very large in size and few are small, medium sized globes. And nowadays we are seeing globes that can be adjusted or kept in the pockets very easily. Pocket globes are there, and few are like inflatable globes. That means whenever we want to use, we have to blow air in that and it will take a shape of a globe. And when we don't want, then we can remove the air and we can keep it wherever we want. So, the large globes, it will be very difficult for us to take it and travel from one place to other, right? Whereas these inflatable globes, whenever we want, according to our usage, we can use. Okay, students, so these are many and few globes are also like they can be hanged from the ceiling. That means they are like decorative pieces on which the continents and countries will be very visibly seen. So, students, we will be having many different points that we can use as reference on the globe. As we see that our Earth, when it is revolving around the sun, will not be straight. It will be tilted. So, it will be about 23 degrees. So, if we have to draw, then we would be drawing something like this. Okay. And suppose that this is our axis. It is tilted for 23.5 degrees. Okay, students. So, now when we are seeing, students, earlier image was little small and not that perfectly circle, no? So, I have drawn it again. So, here you can see that this is our axis. Okay. Now, it is tilted at the angle of 23.5 degrees. Yes. So, first of all, students, we are talking that axis is tilted at 23.5 degrees. So, what is an axis? Axis is nothing but a point on which Earth will be continuously rotating. So that point we are considering it as axis. So students, do you think this line will be present on the Earth also? No, it is an imaginary line. It is an imaginary line, students. So these lines will not be present on the Earth. So when we are comparing the axis with this vertical line, it is showing that it is at 23.5 degrees. Now what about the angle here to the orbital plane? So we know that Earth will be rotating around the sun in its orbit, right? So when we are comparing the axis with the orbital line, then the tilt is almost 66.5 degrees. So as we see with this vertical line, it is 23.5, and this 66.5 is related to the orbital line. So students, if we add this both 23.5 and 66.5, it will be totally, it will be 90 degrees. Yes, so right angle. Okay students, so here we will be having our, to the north, the northernmost is North Pole, and southernmost we have our South Pole, and between we have many latitudes and longitudes. So students, we were talking about the axis, how much angle it is tilted when we are comparing to a vertical line and to the orbital line. So, and the other point of reference is 90 degrees north is nothing but our North Pole. And so here is nothing but North Pole and 90 degrees south, South Pole. Okay students, so these are the other two reference points. So we were talking about the axis, North Pole, South Pole in terms of our reference point. And this is another imaginary line that will be passing through the center of the Earth, and it will divide the Earth into two equal halves. And students, do you know the name of this line? It is equator. At what degree is this present, students? It is present at 0 degrees. Okay, so we don't have any north or south writing to the equator because it is exactly present in the middle. Now the another logic why we keep North Pole at 90 degrees is, well, it exactly meets the equator, it forms a right angle, that is 90 degrees. So that happens same in the case of South Pole. So these poles are placed at 90 degrees. Okay, I hope you all have understood, students. So now if we draw a straight line, they will be intersecting the equator at 90 degrees. They form an right angle. Okay, so it is almost a quarter, just 1/4 of the equator. Now if we consider, this is full is half, and the other side will be another half. So this part is only quarter of the equator. So that is why it is given as 90 degrees. Students, other than the equator and axis, we are having many other imaginary lines that are drawn on the globe. So few will be horizontal lines, and we will be having few vertical lines. So students, these, the lines which I have drawn with the red ink, are called as latitudes, and the ones with the blue are longitudes. So you all know, right, these are also imaginary lines and they do not exist on the Earth. So just for our convenience to locate a place and to know about the time, we will be using the latitudes and the longitudes. So main usage of these latitudes and longitudes is to locate a particular place and to tell about the time. So students, talking about the location of a place and time of the place, so first we will be seeing how a location of a place is told. So students, suppose you order something from online, okay, then how will that person come to your place delivering the object or anything that you have ordered? So they will be having your address, they will be having your location, so seeing that they will be reaching your home. Or else, if they are not able to find your home, then how will you tell them the directions to reach your home? It will be, you come in this gully from left, right, you will be finding this hospital. If you come ahead, there is a medical store. If you come more forward, there is a kirana store. So these are the some relative things. Or else we say, you have to now come towards the north, then move towards the east, 20 meters east. When, suppose, best example students, when we are traveling to a new place, to, nowadays what do we use? We use GPS, Google Maps, right? So it will be how directions or instructions it will be going. It will be saying as 10 meters ahead, 10 meters to the east. More, it is still left, like so and so instructions it will be continuously giving, right? That you have to travel towards north direction or south direction, and you will be crossing through a particular hospital or particular plaza or any shopping mall. It will be giving all these directions and instructions, right? So whenever we use any landmarks or whenever we use any other reference to tell our address, that will be called as relative location. So in short, whenever we tell a location using landmarks or we use say directions, then it is called as relative location. Okay students, now next type of location is called as absolute location. It is called as absolute location, student. So in this type of location, they will be telling proper coordinates of a particular place that they will be getting with the help of latitudes and longitudes. Okay, so if we have to go to a particular place, they will say that it is at 25 degrees north, 35 degrees east. So they will be giving such coordinates. You might have heard in many movies, usually soldiers will be using these satellites or longitudinal or latitudinal coordinates. So for example, we will see now if we have to write location of India. So how do we write our latitudinal and longitudinal locational of India? The latitudinal extent of our India is 37 degrees 6 minutes north to 8 degrees 4 minutes north. And when we talk about longitudinal, it is from 68 degrees 7 minutes east to 97 degrees 25 minutes east. So students, now the longitudinal and latitudinal extent, what I have told, they might be very difficult or very confusing for you. Because you don't know why are this N, E used, what is this minutes. Okay, so these might be very confusing for you now. But once you learn this, it will be very easy. That we will be seeing in the next videos. So first, the thing what you have to remember, when we are giving any absolute location using the latitudinal and longitudinal coordinates, first will be latitude and next will be longitude. So how do we actually use it? For that, we have to wait, and we will be seeing in our next videos. So students, on overall today we have learned about globe, what are the different types of globe and how is it useful, what are the different points of references. Okay, and we have seen the degrees to the orbital plane and how do we tell about a particular location using, sometimes we say using the landmarks or the direction, and sometimes latitudinal and longitudinal extent. Okay, so students, we will be meeting you in the next video. Till then, goodbye, take care.